Hello everyone, myself Dr. Heena Vasdev, Assistant Professor, Faculty of Commerce and Management, SGT University, Gurugram. Today the topic for discussion is Medical Record Department. Medical Record Department is a very crucial department of the hospital. According to Mac Akin, 1957, he described medical record as a clear, concise and accurate history of patient's life and illness according to medical point of view. In general terms, it is basically whom, what, why, where and when patient care is required. Now we move towards the contents of the medical record. We divide the contents of medical record into two parts. First, admission ticket or the registration form that includes the personal and demographic profile of the patient. And next we move towards the case sheet that includes the medical history of the patient, clinical findings of the patients, investigations ordered, treatment instituted, progress notes, and if the patient have gone under any surgical procedure, then consent form is a very necessity in the medical record. Consultation request form, anesthesia check record, if the patient has undergone any operation, then operative notes are also required. Post-operative notes, lab reports have to be kept in the order base. Films are also required in the medical record file. Then discharge summary, TPR chart where the temperature, pulse, respiration is recorded. Next we have the nurse's treatment chart, diet assessment form, ICU notes, physiotherapy notes, and at the last we have medical legal registration if it is applicable to the patient. Now types of medical records. We basically divide medical records into two types, that is directly related to the patient care activities and indirectly related to the patient care activities. When we talk about directly related to the patient care activities, it basically includes the progress report, OT sheet, post-operative sheets. And when we talk about indirectly related to the patient care activities, it basically says that it contains accounts of financial transaction during the patient's stay. Now we'll be discussing the scope and importance of the medical records for patients. For patients, it basically assists in the continuity of the care for future illness, avoid omission, repetition, duplication of medical records, evidence to support medical legal. Next, we have document the story of the patient, provide information for insurance and health schemes. Similar wise, medical records are very useful for the physicians too. It assures quality, quantity and adequacy of the care undertaken, evaluation of the medical care services, protects the physicians from the legal suits, and it also helps in the clinical research for physicians. Now we move towards the scope and importance for the hospitals. Basically documents the evaluation of the medical and the nursing care. It helps in evaluation of the usage of hospital, hence it helps in allocation and planning of the resources. It helps in the clinical research for the physicians and for the hospital too, and it also saves the hospital from the legal suits. Now we move towards the medical education and research. It acts as an informal education. It forms the basis of the clinical research, and it is also the visible information for variable disease process. Now similar wise, the scope and importance of medical records for public health authorities. When we talk about public health authorities, it basically provides the data for mortality and morbidity of the population. It assists in planning and preventive and social measures, provide data for developing national and state health programs, and it also provide early warning of incidents of communicable disease. Next we move towards the functional organization of medical record department. Basically, medical record department should be a part of an administrative ring. Next, it should be the close proximity to the inpatient area, that is IPD area, and the space requirement should be 2 to 3 square feet per bed. Now if we have to do the planning of medical records, for example 200 bedded hospitals. Location, the central admission and inquiry office should be very near to the main entry, that is near to the OPD and emergency. And if we talk about the space, we have different space requirement. For example, for admission and inquiry office, we require 125 to 175 square feet area. For central record office, we require 450 to 500 square feet area. For medical record area, we required 120 to 500 square feet area. For outpatient record section, we basically required 400 to 600 square feet area. Now, if we talk about the staffing, we basically required a computer literate staff for medical record department, in which we basically required 2 medical record technicians and 4 medical record attendants. Next, we move towards the furniture and equipments, that is equipments required for MRD. Furnitures required are basically office chairs and tables, filing racks and cabinets with 4 drawers, card index and patient index cabinets, and at the end we required typewriters, Xerox machines and stationery. Next, we move towards the responsibilities of MRD. Basically, the MRD department designed the hospital forms, they record the census, they also do the verification in correctness for the incomplete records. Then they also file according to the predetermined system that is available in the hospital. Then compiling of the hospital statistics, and it also generates data for hospital administrator, management, audit committees and government health schemes. After the responsibilities of the MRD, we'll discuss the processing of the records. Records are assembled in order, then they are basically inspected according to the standard checklist. All the entries that are scrutinized and then rectified for the same. On the top of the record file, we basically have the standard checklist that indicates all the data that is present in the record file. Vital statistics, that is birth chart, death rate, these are all basically informed to the appropriate authorities. At next, statistical analysis is done. After that, codification of disease is done and storing the complete updated records. Medico-legal records are stored in the separate department or the separate area so that it can be easily accessible. Issue and dispatch register is maintained. Move towards the coding and indexing. Coding is basically done according to the International Code of Disease, and indexing is basically done on the basis of alphabetical or the master index, disease index, operation index, physician index and unit index. In basically operation index, statistical data is done at every patient that is undergone basic types of operations or under basic types of physicians. Next, we move towards storage and retrieval. We basically store data in the 3 forms. First, we have the manual form and then we have the electronic medical record. Electronic medical record is basically computer-based patient medical record, which restructures and optimizes the interoperability of the document system for all the patient, ensuring all the documentation system. Next, we have microfilming, that is filming of the records in the miniature form. After all this, we'll go for the filing data. Factors that affect basically the filing system are compactness, so that we can have the reduce the cost of the storage. Then accessibility, so that we can have the speedy recovery. Simplicity for understanding of all concerned, economical and elasticity for the future expansion. System of filing. The filing is basically done into 2 types. We have the decentralized system and we have the centralized system. When we talk about the decentralized system, in that OPD and IPD, both departments have their own individual records. So it basically have the high operating cost. And if we talk about the centralized system, it basically records the main centrally in the MRD department. So it has the more efficient and it provides better control. Now we move towards the medico-legal aspects. When we talk about the medico-legal records, the hospital is the owner of the medical records. Not either a patient or any relative are the owner of the medical records. So according to Indian Evidence Act, which suggests that the medical records can be produced only under the following situation: when it is asked under the Civil Code, Consumer Code, Criminal Code, or under we have the Life Insurance Corporation of India, or it is asked under income tax or patient's will or any inquiry regarding birth and death rate. So according to IMC Regulation 2002, which says that the medical records, if it is asked, then that should be produced within the period of 72 hours. Retention of medical records. General guidelines have been given in which OPD files have to be kept for 5 years, IPD data has to be kept for 10 years, and for medico-legal cases, we require the retention for lifetime. So in medical records, we basically have to process the records, then we have to do indexing, then we have to do coding, storage, and after that, filing of records is required. Thank you.